morning. At this time, I'd ask that all but the immediate family would please go in and be seated. We will prepare to come in. So, excluding the immediate family, to stay, everybody else, please go in and be seated.
We return to the seats that we've come before.
Thank you. those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. In the world, you have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Please be seated. Good morning, all, and welcome all to this celebration of the life of Gifty Owusu-Ansah, who died on Thursday, the 13th of July, 2023, at the age of 46 years old. On behalf of the Kentia and Owusu-Ansah families, I present to you all my heartfelt condolences. My name is Charles Ilunga. So as we gather to remember and say goodbye to Gifty, let me at this point remind all of us to switch off our phones. And also to say that this service will be immediately followed by burial at Grove Park Cemetery. We will stand to sing our first hymn, Abide With Me. It is a very well-known hymn. The hymn is the honor service. we come into your presence this day to mourn the passing of Gifty Owusu-Ansah. Lord, we also come to celebrate the life of a sister, a mother, and a friend. In such sad moment, we come to be comforted, and we would like you to comfort us in our sorrows, and to pray that your Spirit would cover us with peace that passes all understanding. Eternal Father, our heavenly Creator, from you we come, and to you we go. We ask you to grant us the favor of your presence at this time in our earthly pilgrimage. Assure us by your Holy Spirit that Jesus, your Son, the one we serve, has conquered death, and he is alive forever. Enable us, Lord, to view our short lives in the light of the eternal. And so may our spirit grow calm, and our vision be clear. Help us to listen to your voice and guidance. All this we pray through Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Going to read the scripture, and this is Psalm chapter 23, verses from 1 to 6. Psalm 23, 1 to 6. The Lord is my shepherd. I have everything I need. He lets me rest in fields of green grass and leads me to quiet pools of fresh water. He gives me new strength. He guides me in the right paths, as he has promised. Even if I go through the deepest darkness, I will not be afraid. Lord, for you are with me. Your shepherd's rod and staff protect me. You prepare a banquet for me, where all my enemies can see me. You welcome me as an honored guest, and you fill my cup to the brim. I know that your goodness and love will be with me all my life, and your house will be my home as long as I live. These are words of faith. And if we are in this room, it is because we believe in our Creator. So at this time, let me invite Elizabeth Kentia to give us the eulogy.
For if we live, we live for the Lord.
or if we die, we die for the Lord. Therefore, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. Gifty Owusu-Ansah was born on 10th August 1977 in Takrady to the late Mary Ose and the late Emmanuel Randolph Owusu-Ansah after they returned to Ghana after several years of living in the UK. Gifty is the sixth of seven children by the late Mary Ose and the fourth of five by her late father Emmanuel Randolph Owusu-Ansah. Her siblings are James, Eddie, Josephine, Ben, Henry, Ian, Colin, Richard, and a stepbrother, Victor. Life as a child began in Takoradi before moving to Accra, Kumasi, Takoradi, and back to Kumasi with their family. As Gifty's father worked as a property manager for GNTC and was transferred across the country. Gifty started her education at Ramana Basic School in Accra, then attended Services 1 Primary School in Takoradi, where she attained several awards. She sat the common entrance examination at age 11 and was admitted to Yaa Asantewaa Girls Secondary School in Kumasi from Form 1 to Upper 6. She furthered her education at the Institute of Marketing Studies. She then went on to work in an administrative role at the Kumasi Abattoir and engaged in some buying and selling until she returned to education. Gifty married in 2001 and was blessed with two wonderful children, Gideon and Mireille. Gifty was persuaded to return to university by her brother after her marriage separation, and she enjoyed a very successful 2 years of a three-year graduate course at Christian University, pursuing a course in business finance until she developed a mystery illness in 2009. That would alter the course of a peaceful life until then. Gifty developed nerve issues, which was later described as a rare form of MS that led to her losing her eyesight dramatically and painfully. Gifty embraced this challenging part of her life with her faith. She was a staunch Christian and attended church relentlessly. She was a single mother to her two children, proactively promoting their education and ensuring they maintained and developed positive behavior traits that would stand them in good stead beyond her days. She maintained a structured household with clear routines and mastered her environment to the extent that many people that visited her were astonished when told she was blind. Gifty enjoyed her life and remained optimistic about her future, even in the most challenging of circumstances. Gifty oversaw both her children successfully pass their exams and gain admission to Kwame Nkrumah University Science and Technology after years of additional tuition and home learning to supplement their formal education at secondary school. Gifty was diagnosed with breast cancer in January 2023 and was supported to travel to the UK for treatment. A positive consultation with an experienced oncology team at Harvey Street had provided us with great hope and optimism, but sadly this was not realized. Then we lost our gem of a mother, sister-in-law, and aunt on 13 July 2023 at Lewisham Hospital. Gifty received great support from her siblings in the UK, but a special mention is deserved for her in-laws, Efe, Efia, Anita, and her cousin Naima, who stood by the family shoulder to shoulder, providing practical and emotional support until her last breath. Gifty left a positive memory on all of us, including everyone she met at Abbey Street and Lewisham Hospital during her last days on this earth. She was at peace with herself and confronted death with dignity and without fear. She prayed at every opportunity and found an inner strength that can only be from God. Gifty was survived by several nieces and nephews: Jordan, Josiah, Sylvester, Gladys, Ronnie, Kevin, Eddie, Whitney, Shondell, Mireille, Eddie Jr., Frank, Jessica, Zachary, Michelle, Nathan, Bradley, Thomas, Sean, Giselle, Jordan, Jeffrey, Janelle, Odell, Edward, Jaden, Madison, Jason, Vincentia, Gisla, and Brenda. We have lost a sister, a mother, an aunt, an in-law, and a friend her memory lives on. We are blessed with Gifty two children and many great memories. She is gone, but she will never be forgotten. We conclude with the following code. Death takes the body, our minds hold the memories, our hearts keep the love, our faith let us know we will meet again. Rest well, Gifty. Demi-fa-ji.
Now let us listen to the word of God as it's been read by Polina Hussein.
Second reading is taken from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1 to 8. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1 to 8. A time for everything. Everything that happens in this world happens at the time God chooses. He sets a time for birth and a time for death, a time for planting and a time for pulling up, a time for killing and a time for healing, a time for tearing down and a time for building. He sets a time for sorrow and a time for joy, a time for mourning and a time for dancing, a time for making love and a time for not making love, a time for kissing and a time for not kissing. He sets the time for finding and a time for losing, a time for saving and a time for throwing away, a time for tearing and a time for mending, a time for silence and a time for talk. In the last verse, he sets the time for love and a time for hate, a time for war and a time for peace.
Amen. Let us stand and sing our second hymn. Can we hold our breath to God?
Through his fiery love.
Please be seated. This is the time now we, different people are going to pay tributes to Sister Gifty. So, I'm sure everybody has got the order of service, so we will first hear the tribute given by Edward, followed by Gideon, who will just come after, following how it is led also on the order of service.
This tribute on behalf of all the siblings. A lot of us are here, but there's also a couple of them that are in the US and also in Ghana. I wish I was reading this today, but God knows best. Mommy baby, as I affectionately call you, this is not how we planned it when we left Ghana. The medical treatment here in the UK in March of 2023. Our immediate and long-term dreams and plans that we discussed fondly together have been dramatically cut short, and as a family, we have all been left shocked and empty. There was never a dull moment with you, Gifty, and it's for that that I wish you to be remembered. To me and the rest of your siblings, we have lost an amazing woman, mother, and sister. The gaping hole that you've left can never be filled, but in our pain, we rejoice in the many great memories we shared together. You have endured more than most in the last 15 years, with illness, but throughout these difficult years, you kept your tenacity and smile, and even in the darkest moments, you showed fight that will inspire me, your children, your siblings, your in-laws, your nieces and nephews, and all who came into contact with you for as long as we live. I witnessed and admired how your dedicated faith in Christ gave you strength beyond the norm and enabled you to maintain a resolve and dignity until your very last breath. As a single mother, you were exceptional. You took charge of your house when it came to the welfare of your children. You left your children with strong Christian foundations and morals that have seen them grow into an ambitious and respectful young man and woman who are progressing at university. You were never one to shy away from expressing your opinion. And you also loved life and people. The two things or simply a great tune. You loved a good tasty meal and a good party. I recall fondly the gospel songs you, Ife and I shared on our way to treatment weekly at Harley Street, and the great personal chats we had. Our baby loved a good gospel too, even as she lay unwell in the high dependency unit at Lewisham Hospital. She knew and had a view on everybody's business and whatever was going on around the world. While in the UK, she enjoyed a good chatter with her nieces and nephews and spoke of them proudly and offered advice on all issues, including behavior and pitfalls of relationships and marriage. She quickly learned some street terms as fam and mate while she offered them lessons in basic trade. Auntie Baby was looking forward to being chauffeured around by them, visiting historic sites, and attending an Arsenal football match as she improved from her treatment. Sadly, the icy hands of death have ended all these dreams. We also never got to mark her 46th birthday on the 10th of August 2023, a birthday that she shared with our late mom. Baby was forever grateful for all the support she received from my family and her siblings and their families in the 15 years since she mysteriously lost her sight. In her last hours, as she lay very unwell, she would still muster a smile for everyone. Anyone that came to see and pray with her at the hospital. I will never forget her waving to me after a visit 2 days before she passed, pulling my hands to her mouth and planting a kiss on it, clearly saying her goodbyes. We're broken, devastated, and in despair. But I'm consoled by the knowledge that our baby is in a good place in heaven where there is no more pain. We will move forward with God and will carry out our commitment to ensure her children have pride and joy are supported into adulthood. Rest in peace, dear sister, my love. Rest in peace till we meet.
Today, we gather to honor the life and legacy of the two remarkable women, my mother, Gifty, Owusu-Ansah. It is with a heavy heart and deep sadness that I bid her farewell, but it is also with immense gratitude and admiration for the incredible person she was. My mother's love was an inherent force that radiated from her being. Her love for her children was unwavering and unconditional. It was a love that knew no bounds and transcended all obstacles. Her love was a guiding light, a source of strength, and a constant reminder of what it means to truly care for another human being. Her nurturing nature was inherent in every aspect of her life. From the countless meals she prepared with love to the comforting hugs she offered during times of sorrow, my mother's ability to care for others was a gift that she shared selflessly. She had an innate understanding of what it meant to be a mother, to provide comfort, support, and guidance. And she fulfilled that role with grace and compassion. My mother's kindness and generosity were inherent qualities that touched the life of everyone she encountered. She had a heart that overflowed with empathy and a genuine desire to help those in need. Whether it was offering a listening ear, lending a helping hand, or simply brightening someone's day with a smile. My mother had an innate ability to make others feel seen, heard, and loved. Her strength and resilience were traits that carried her through life's challenges. My mother faced adversity with unwavering determination and an unyielding spirit. She never let setbacks define her or dampen her spirit. Instead, she used them as a fuel to propel herself forward, emerging stronger and more resilient each time. Her ability to persevere in the face of adversity was an inspiration to all who knew her. Mother's wisdom and guidance were gifts that she shared generously. She possessed an innate understanding of life's complexities and had a unique ability to offer guidance and support in times of uncertainty. Her words of wisdom were like beacons of light, illuminating the path ahead and providing comfort in times of darkness. As we say our final goodbyes to my mother, let us remember the inherent qualities that made her the extraordinary woman she was. Her love, nurturing nature, kindness, strength, resilience, and wisdom will forever live on in my heart. She leaves behind a legacy of love and a profound impact on all who had the privilege of knowing her. May we find solace in knowing that my mother's spirit will forever be with us, guiding us and reminding us to cherish the inherent goodness within ourselves and others.
Today, we come as one to acknowledge a life well lived, a hero and a legend who left indelible marks on the lives of many in a little time spent together. We are here with heavy hearts, but also with a head held up high to honor a very prodigious woman, Gifty Owusu-Ansah, my mother and everything. My words below are not just everyday words, but words put together of a wonderful and lifetime experience with a unique person. Of all rights of women, the greatest is to be a mother, Lin Yu Tang. Motherhood is a very difficult and uneasy task to take on as it comes to men, but a few to take up as rights to handle all that it comes with. An uneasy task, juggling the role of parenting in raising children isn't just for a minute, an hour, or a day. I never came back home to meet a pessimistic atmosphere, a sorrowful heart, or an unhappy person, but rather a strong-willed and an optimistic woman with a persevering spirit who lived life with their head held up high. A heart so strong, but humble to all, and a smile through all happenings in life. This is who my mother was. Her strength overcome each passing day. Her spirit and heart of resilience is something to admire, as I've never seen such in my life. The strongest of all, my hero. The purest and sincerest love shown, you have shown many, and the support you have given many, as few to do the impossible, isn't something so easy to come by. Who lives their happiness and well-being and seeks for another to have it all? Your happiness and arrays of love, light and beauty inside out, that shine so bright and defines a woman's true essence, is to be admired and appreciated. Thank you wouldn't be enough to express my profound gratitude for all the sacrifices you have laid down for us. A heart that loves all, a love that knows no bounds, a selfless person with an exceptional love for all. An irreplaceable one. This is This is who my mother was. A legend. Out of this love, your sense of discipline and wisdom from you, and overcoming it all, never failed to. In so many ways, you have steered our lives and the lives of many. A woman adorned with beauty, inside out, and great with wisdom. Such an incredible being my mother was. You can also define my mother as a person of strong belief in her faith in God. There is a God, she would say. Do not ever lose your faith in him. He is always near, she would say. God will always come through for you. And God has done it already. A woman with an unbreakable faith, that is my mom. Through you, we have known, experienced, and met a man so faithful, so loving, so kind. A God so true that he never indeed left your side, nor our side. Through it all, a promising God who always came through, even as we speak. If there is anyone or anything that we may face, we know that your God is with us, and you will be with us too. To the woman who changed our lives in many ways, I am beyond proud, blessed, and privileged to call you my mother. I am beyond proud, blessed, and privileged to call you my mother. Even as you depart from us physically, in our hearts, you always remain dear to us. Your great sacrifices and selflessness, your heart of resilience, your love, your beauty inside out, that shines so bright, your wisdom and directions, your strong faith, your happy spirit, all is to say that you are indeed a true definition of perfection, a hero and a legend. Gideon and I will never. Gideon and I will never forget you, as nothing can take away a love our hearts hold so dear, and all we have shared. We miss you so much, with every passing time and day. With a love so, with a love so strong, your daughter. Thank
I bring this tribute on behalf of Auntie Baby's niece and nephews. Gifty Owusu-Ansah, as Auntie Baby, was a remarkable woman whose legacy will remain in the hearts of those of us who remain. Auntie Baby was a warm, kind, and bubbly person who always saw the beauty in the hardest of circumstances, whether it was at parties with family and friends, within the church, or unfortunately, her time spent at the hospital. Auntie Baby's smile never wavered, and her faith in God never faltered. Never was there anyone more devout and God-fearing, and it was Auntie Baby's strength in Christ that saw her persevere through all obstacles and challenges that came her way. Even while she resided in a hospital bed, Auntie Baby always prioritized her role as a mother, an aunt, and a sister. Her concern was always how others were doing, how her children were faring, and she excitedly awaited fun updates and talking points with her nieces and nephews. As we visited the hospital, she would always remind us to wash our hands and take care of our health. Auntie Baby truly left her mark on this earth, and she can now rest comfortably in heaven at the Lord's side. Her children, Gideon and Marie, always remained at the forefront of their mother's thoughts, and she would smile fondly at the mere mention of them, and was very proud of the young man and woman they have grown up to be. As we continue to mourn the loss of our beloved Auntie Baby, we consider the following words. To live on in the hearts of those we love is never to die. In this, we all take solace and comfort in the understanding that Auntie Baby will live on in the moments we've all shared with her and the lives she has impacted. Her story is one of life, love, perseverance, and triumph, and teaches us all to see the beauty in every day and make the most of every aspect of life, just as she did.
I read this on behalf of all the sisters in us, written by our senior sister, Elizabeth. It feels very strange talking about you in the past, Ekuma. All your in-laws have related in very various ways with you and can pick out moments that we best sum up the relationship we have enjoyed with you. I have known you for over 34 years, my sister-in-law and me, maybe 20-something, and vividly remember the cute girl I met for the first time at my mother-in-law's house in Ishaesu. Gifty was headstrong, funny, and had a matter-of-fact approach at life situations. She would call a spade and spoke her mind regardless of the consequences. She was a fighter and forged ahead despite all the curveballs life threw at her. She continued to live her life to the fullest despite losing her sight suddenly in 2009 and adopted the same approach after her diagnosis of cancer in January 2023. Over the years, and especially after you lost your sight in 2009, I was fortunate enough to witness the wonderful and loving bond between you and your husband, Eddie, my husband Eddie, and my, by default, also had a long-standing relationship with you. I remember your happiness at parties during our yearly visits to Ghana, and the joy and fulfillment on your face at the sound of Eddie's voice, and most recently the excitement from your hospital bed at the sound of Gideon and Mireille's voice, despite being in a great deal of pain. Your priority always was your children, and I still remember how overjoyed you were on your hospital bed at the news that they passed their exams for their first semester. I also remember our singing together to gospel music with Eddie during our weekly trips to Harley Street for treatment. The numerous thank you to Eddie and I for everything and also for opportunity to come to the UK despite the awful circumstances you found yourself in. Seeing life slowly ebbing, seeing life slowly ebbing from you during our daily visits to the hospital was excruciatingly painful. The poignant moment was when you held Eddie's hand, squeezed it, and then held it to your mouth to kiss it 2 days before your death. You even mastered the strength to squeeze mine too.
That was when I knew without a doubt that the end was near, and that was your way of saying goodbye. Baby, the plans we made for your 46th birthday and continue to talk about on your hospital bed never came to pass. Although you are not here with us, you will always be present in our hearts, and we will continue to take comfort in the amazing memories we all shared with you and the footprints left through your children. Your legacy will live through them, and the love you brought to their hearts will live on forever. Rest well, baby, in the loving arms of our God. Thank you.
Our third Bible scripture will be taken from 1 Thessalonians chapter 1, verses 13 and 14. Chapter 4, verses 13 and 14. Our brothers and sisters, we want you to know the truth about those who have died, so that you will not be sad, as are those who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will take back with Jesus those who have died, believing in him.
Amen.
Us here together to hear as people testify of how different people have carried the faith and to be also encouraged. Lord, we know that your word has been read, and we know that nobody is able to preach if you do not. So speak to us as we try to understand what has been read from this epistle to the Thessalonians. I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditation of our thoughts be acceptable to you, Lord our Redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
We all have heard. I know that many of us, like me, tears were dripping out of our eyes to listen to all different things said about this woman. My dear friends and family, we are here today in the shadow of grief and loss, seeking comfort and understanding as we bid farewell to Gifty, Owusu-Ansah. And in times like this, indeed, as Christians, we are invited, and I invite you to turn our attention to the world of Psalm chapter 34, verse 18. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. Psalm chapter 73 says, my flesh and my heart fails, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. Matthew chapter 5, verse 4. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. The Apostle Paul says, we live by faith and not by sight. We are confident, and we would prefer to leave the body and to be at home with the Lord. In his first letter to the Thessalonians, we have heard specifically Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13, which has been just read here, 2:14, we are provided with hope. We hear, brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be uninformed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve like the rest of mankind who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep, who have died in him. In these verses, brother and sister, Paul offers us a message of hope and reassurance, a message that reminds us that even in our darkest moment, there is light to be found. Paul acknowledges that grief is a natural response to the loss of a loved one. Yes, we cry. I can tell you that I was crying here. We should not suppress our grief because it is a testament or a proof to the love we had for Gifty. However, Paul also says, urges us not to grieve like those who have no hope. What does this mean? It means that as followers of Christ, we have a hope that transcends the pain. I heard this word from the mouth of God, the pain. Of this moment. Our hope is grounded in the life, the death, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Just as Jesus conquered death, so too will those who have placed their faith in him. This is the foundation of our hope. Paul's words reminds us of the resurrection, hope. We believe that just as Christ rose from the dead, Gifty, Owusu-Ansah will also rise to eternal life. Death is not the end for those who believe. It is a transition into a glorious eternal existence with our Creator. Yes, there are people who still are joking up until now, who allow themselves to say, there is no God. You lie. Hear the word that has been expressed by Mireille. You have it in your hall of service. This hope brings us comfort. To have the comfort in those words. It offers us a profound perspective on death. It is not a goodbye forever. We are bidding to Gifty, but only goodbye for now. We can't take comfort. We can take comfort in knowing that we will one day be reunited with our loved ones. Where there will be no more tears, no more pain, only joy and eternal fellowship. Paul's message reminds us of the power of our faith. Our faith is not a simple intellectual exercise. It is a living, vibrant connection to the eternal. It sustains us in our grief and gives us the strength to face the uncertainty of life and death. In this time of mourning, let us hold onto our faith, for it is our anchor. It is the source of our hope, the wellspring of our comfort, and the assurance of our reunion with Gifty in the presence of our loving Father, God the Creator, the Almighty. Amen. the ancient of the days. As we say our final earthly goodbye to Gifty, let us remember these words from Thessalonians and find comfort in our home. Let us grieve, but not as those without hallelujah. Let us hold on to the promise of the resurrection and the eternal life that awaits for those who believe. May God's peace, which surpasses all understanding, guide our hearts and minds. In Jesus' name. Let us sing "When Peace Like a River."
into your keeping, O merciful God. We commend your servant, Gifty Owusu-Ansah. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the joy of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints. In light, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So we say the Lord's Prayer together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Musical tribute. The Goodness of God by Sissy, by Martina Cathy. Yes.
Before I sing, I just wanted to say thank you. I always count it a privilege to come and sing the song. Pause it 1 second. I always count it a privilege to sing. Anybody has passed, but I just want to say that I see a strength in you, and it is beautiful. She will continue to live through the two of you, especially the really extended family. And God is close to those who mourn, so in any time that you only have a sigh or you don't have a word, just know that your words, your non-spoken, your sigh, your silence is heard and is felt by God. Yes. Okay, so yes, I'm gonna sing.
Of the goodness of God.
not. We need to seek our happiness of ourselves. Indeed, we seem to have done very well. We are even finishing a letter. Before we listen to the exit music, I will invite the family, that is Edward, for the vote of thanks and information, and then if I will also invite the undertaker, the man who has just come to talk to me now, to join in as the announcement is being given to us. So Edward, can we invite the undertaker who was with us here so that we can join in the announcement.
God is good.
All the time.
Pleased to know that I'm not going to give a sermon. It's been wonderful, and I think at this point it's about us saying our thank yous. And it's a long journey that has gotten us here. And on behalf of the family back home, Openye Abuja is the head of the family. We have Sam Kwame, who's in the US, Mami Dora, and the whole of the families that couldn't be here today, is to say a big thank you to everybody that's here present today. But as I said, the journey didn't just start today. We had a few traumatic months leading up to this, but also some great ones, and people coming up from the woodwork. We mentioned, I think, Elizabeth in our eulogy mentioned a few people who put themselves out and did what, you know, was beyond the call of duty. So I thank you all. If I start mentioning names, I might leave somebody out and I get myself in trouble. So what I'm going to do is, but I'll just say thank you all. You know yourselves, the family, some of you are so close that I don't make the distinction. But you put yourself out there for us, and we're forever grateful, forever indebted. Today's a Friday. Some of you have left work to come and join us. Some of you are with us in the hospital, day in, day out, giving Gifty love, prayers. I'm looking to my wonderful junior wife, Anita. Wife, Elizabeth, Nana, and a whole lot more. They came in and stood there, you know, and it's difficult sometimes when you're in a situation where looking after somebody that's in the world, and those of you that are carers, I remember one day just popping down and going off course a little bit and bumping into my dear friend Prince. I wasn't expecting him, the man was there with a Bible, praying for her. And although she was worse for wear, she had her senses around her and did a wonderful job. And so many of you have come out and done amazing things for us. I don't think words can describe. But we thank you on behalf of everybody. And I may, as I said at the beginning, missed out a few of you. Please forgive me. It's difficult. I never envisaged for a minute. It was never part of the plan, as I said at the beginning, to be standing here reading a tribute about my dear sister. But that is the way of the Lord. And we're thankful that we're here to be able to mark this occasion. And I'm hoping that this is the first bit of it. There's another challenge. The kids did admirably well, and everybody else to make it a great occasion. We will leave here and we'll go to Hill Green Cemetery. The pastor said that Grove Park is Hill Green. Hill Green Cemetery. We are a bit ahead of schedule. And then what happens after that, there'll be some, we'll have the burial service there, and then there'll be some snacks And then tomorrow, we get to do it again at the Oasis Academy in Shirley. For those of you that know, Croydon, it's about 5 minutes away from Gold Coast.
Yeah.
And so I'm hoping that, you know, those of you that are able to come, we'll see you again there. And then again, we get to say thank you. I mean, this is about you guys taking time and being there for us in our time of need. And I hope that we have, not in this way, but have a chance to reciprocate. And thank you so much for your time, your energy, your effort, all your donations, your words of wisdom, your prayers, is what's kept me standing here. Because these are tough times, but when you have so many loving people around you, your WhatsApps, your text messages and everything, it keeps us strong and will keep us strong going forward. So thank you very much.
Let us hear some other announcement from the lead, somebody who is leading us.
Good afternoon to each and every one of you. To our dear brother, to piggyback on what you said, yes, we will be going to Hill of Green, but we have been quite timely today, so we will commence earlier than planned, as you might know. So we will have the committal, the graveside service will begin at 1. As we leave out, we will have time for you to greet each other, and we will leave from here probably at 12:15, leaving off. So from the yard. So don't rush. You're able to greet each other, and then we will leave. So we'll be timely at the. Thank you very much.
So therefore, I'm going to invite the
Gifty
Graveside Service to be here, or you come and collect the coffin and we go out. As the coffin goes out, the exit music will be played and we will follow.
I'm going to go to the next one.